noon, every one. Okay, just kidding. We're best friends, but we're not gonna put you through that for a whole speed. Anyways, I'm Julia Dilhoff, and I'm Rachel Engel. And first of all, we wanna say thank you. Thank you to our families who supported our wildest aspirations. Thank you to our teachers who motivated us to keep working hard. And thank you to our friends who are always there for us and make life fun. Without everyone in this arena, we would not be where we are today, because no one achieves greatness by themselves. Now, some of us may underestimate the achievement that it is to be standing here today, but to be graduating, especially from Loveland High School, is a great accomplishment and a privilege that many are not as fortunate to receive. Education is an invaluable gift. It's the most vital tool for empowerment and emboldens people to live courageously. It provides a solid foundation with which you can shape the world. So it's imperative today that we recognize how endlessly blessed we have been to have spent our time at Loveland High School. Loveland is a place like no other. We are blessed to live in a tight-knit community that truly cares for one another. At Loveland, our teachers care about us, not just in the classroom, but outside of it. At Loveland, our administrators go to our events and know us by name. At Loveland, we band together and have shown an unstoppable impact. While many of us may say we can't wait to get out of this old little town, one day we're going to miss it. We're going to miss the smiling faces that we pass by every day. We're going to miss our community members who support each other in incredible ways. We're going to miss little old Loveland, where one thing is clear, we love each other. Loveland has given us a high school experience that has indelibly molded us. These high school years we have had have essentially mirrored a musical piece, where we all became composers. In music, you need to build a basis before you start decorating the piece. Freshman year parallels the building of a basic chord progression. It's a foundation, but there's still a long way to go for full expression.
So, let's flash back 4 years and several pounds ago. We walk into these halls as freshmen, some nervous, some excited, but mostly nervous. Soon, we found our friends, our interests, our niche.
Next comes sophomore and junior year. The notes started to fall more into place, and we began to find our melody. The playing becomes more clear, and our style becomes smoother.
Now that we're comfortable, it's time to set goals for ourselves. Make the varsity team, get straight A's, be one of Mrs. Johnson's fall fashionistas of the day. In order to achieve these goals, we have to work hard. But despite hard work, we can't always succeed.
Inevitably, as the piece becomes more complex, mistakes are made, and a few wrong notes may be played.
So yes, we fell down a couple times, and we're not just talking about the stairs at school. But what did we do? We got back up. That right there is what makes our class so special. Perseverance. Our failures are not failures until we let them define us. Our failures are the moments in life that shape who we are. Because it's easy to accept a win, but the true test in life is how we respond to our losses. Therefore, we cannot see our failures as something to be afraid of, but as an opportunity to learn and grow.
And finally, we're here, senior year. We've learned so much about ourselves, and we have found our harmonies as well, every different progression of notes playing some small part in the overall movement.
Yes, we did do more than nerf wars and failing to get a senior prank approved. In senior year, we've had to reflect upon ourselves, our past, and our future. What do we want to do with our lives? What is our calling? We are blessed with a variety of talents and passions, and now is the time to find them and use them, because right now, our possibilities are infinite.
Together, we have walked through milestones that will always mark our stories. We have shaped each other's lives in inexplicable ways. Through high school, we have deepened our understanding of not just the pages of a textbook, but of ourselves and of society. After having grown with all of you for 4 years, there's one thing we are certain of. You are all future innovators, trailblazers, and world changers. The potential in this arena is overwhelming.
As we reach the conclusion of these years today, it is important to recognize one thing. Now is your time to be bold. We challenge you. Whatever your next endeavor in life is, find your passion and pursue it. Take the risk and try what you didn't get to in high school.
Do not be scarce with your ambition, and don't take embarrassment in absurd aspirations. Embrace them fully. Dream abundantly and work even harder to get there. As we walk out into the world today, you're given a blank sheet of music to write your song. Take advantage of this opportunity. Become the best version of yourself. Go out and compose your own symphony.
While our times in high school have been amazing, let's not dwell at the door being closed. Let's celebrate the doors to the world that have been opened before us. No matter what path we choose to take in life, it is important to always remember to work hard, be kind, and stay humble.
For as Michelle Obama once said, when you've worked hard and done well and walked through that door of opportunity, you do not slam it shut behind you. You reach back and give other folks the same chances that helps you succeed. So let us not forget the unparalleled privilege we've been given with what we have learned, and let us aspire to go out and make the world a better place.
Here comes the sun, rising upon the next chapter of our lives. Let's face the world fearlessly.
Now we're cooking with gas.
Here we are.